Yeah.
So we're here in the town of St. Anthony. We rolled in last night, probably around 11 o'clock. We spent the night just outside the bargain shop in a big parking lot. I have no idea what the town looks like, so we're going to go explore it really quick. Probably check out a cafe, see if there's anything else here to offer while we're here, and then we're going to head up to Anse Aux Meadows for the day and explore all the little Viking settlements. So we drove all the way to St. Anthony and are most likely only going to see the Rebel Coffee House while here. We really like our coffee and our cafes. Alright, so we got our coffee. I wasn't expecting it in the to-go cup, it's okay. So now we're just gonna drive to Anse Aux Meadows. There's not much else to do here. Come on, let's go. If you're coming all the way to this part of Newfoundland just for St. Anthony, totally depends on you and your personality. For us, probably didn't even need to see St. Anthony. I think we're gonna be quite content with just doing Anse Aux Meadows. All right, so one thing we've noticed on this trip is that it's really hard to find dumping stations and places to fill up on water. We've never had a problem anywhere else in Canada, but it seems like Newfoundland, it's few and far between. So we are at a St. Anthony Fire Department, and there is a dump site and water here. So we're going to fill up dumper tanks and make our way to Anse Aux Meadows. Okay, so we've been running into this couple from Quebec since the ferry in Argentia, and we've literally ran into them everywhere. Like everywhere in Newfoundland we've been, they've been, and we've even passed them on the highway and we've give them a big wave. So it's just been so much fun. We're all the way in Anse Aux Meadows and we pull up and their RV is right next to us. So I've written them a little note and have left it on their dashboard with a big bonjour, because that's how we greet each other when we see each other, and it's just been so much fun. So I hope we run into them right now and we can take a photo with them, because it's just been so much fun.
Okay, we're at the visitor center at Anse Aux Meadows. The guide was very informative. He told us to head straight down to the archaeological site because it wasn't very busy. So he suggested with the kids to go now so they get a good experience, because otherwise apparently it gets quite busy and all the kids would see are the people's backs. So we're heading down to the archaeological site now and we're going to check it out.
Anse Aux Meadows is the first and only known site established by Vikings in North America and the earliest evidence of European settlement in the New World. This archaeological site consists of 8 timber-framed turf structures built in the same style as those found in Norse Greenland and Iceland from the same period. The buildings include 3 dwellings, 1 forge, and 4 workshops. Parks Canada has set up events where you can take part in an evening of Viking myth and storytelling, from the Vinland sagas to ancient folktales, in an intimate hour-long performance warmed by the kitchen fire. It was a unique educational experience we were grateful to share with our children.
We
just checked out the Viking settlement and we learned all about how the Vikings came over from Greenland to collect the timber to take back so that they could build houses back in Greenland. And we got to see what the women did. There's a women's workroom where they were knitting. It's very educational. We're going to go learn some more in the Discovery Center now.
Okay, so we learned there's a common misconception that not every Norse person or people from Norway are Vikings. So apparently you're only a Viking once you go on an expedition and you do some pillaging and some raiding, and that's how you become a Viking. Otherwise, if you're from Norway, you're just a Norse person, not a Viking.
All right, now we're checking out the Norstead settlement. So it's not ran by Parks Canada. It, for a family of four, it's $40. The other one was $25 through Parks Canada, unless you have your Discovery Pass.
Norstead replicates a Viking port of trade as it may have looked during the Viking era. The site has a boat shed with its very own Viking ships, including the 54-foot replica Viking Gnar, which sailed from Greenland to Anse Aux Meadows in 1998 with a crew of only 9 men.
So this right here is a Gnar ship, which was apparently a cargo ship back in the day. It's a recreation of the type of boats that the Norse people would have sailed over here from Greenland. We got a bunch of information about it. It's very cool.
There is also a chieftain's hall, a church, and a workshop with costume interpreters who bring the site to life. All of the buildings have been created to convey the look and feel of the Viking era. It costs more than the Anse Aux Meadows Historic Site, but if you are in the area, we highly recommend you make the time to check out both sites, as they each have their own unique style to share the history of the Vikings and the Norsemen.
So we're checking out some of the buildings. We just learned a new game called Mula, or Nine Man's Mill. It's kind of like a modern-day tic-tac-toe. It's a lot of fun. Kids got to play, and we're going to try making it at home. See if they would keep mom.
You like to try the bellows?
Do you want to try that, Lux?
Pumping the air through the fire.
Or Ivy, do you want to try it?
Between the two.
Knife.
It could be, but I'm just shaping for some nails or an esso.
Good job, Ivy. In your strawberry dress.
Yeah.
Turned out very good, but
what do you think, Lux? Is it cool?
It is.
As your hat blows off.
So at the Norse, there's a lot of really, really interesting educational little houses and huts you can go and tour through and find out what they were used for. And then there's a beautiful view up a big hill that we're doing now.
Didn't expect that we were going to be climbing up the side of a mountain here. So Michelle and I wear these awesome hiking shoes. So anyway, it's doable. View is beautiful.
We are done the Anse Meadows and Norseman portion of today, but we got recommended by our tour guide on the Gros Morne Western Brook Tour to stop at Skipper Hops and tell them that we know Tom Payne. And it's actually going to be our last opportunity to try and get Mike screeched in on this trip, because after tomorrow we're probably off the island of Newfoundland and on to Labrador.
So it turns out it's a lot harder to get screeched in Newfoundland than you thought, especially if it's not a Friday night. So instead of getting screeched in, I settled for the local IPA. It's called Freya's Feathered Cloak. We'll try it in Labrador.
Join us next time for our final episode as we hop on a ferry to the Big Land, where we drive through all kinds of weather on the Trans-Labrador Highway and experience the worst black flies of our life.